Hello everyone, I am Gyan and you are learning computer science with Python for class 11th. In this video, we are going to learn about range function in Python. The range function. Range is a function which, when called, results a sequence, perhaps a list. Why I'm saying it perhaps? Because whatever a data is returned by the range function, that behaves like a list, but it never says that it is list. You may be confused, but first let's assume that the range function returns a list. Then see the behavior of the range function. So if we assume that a range function returns a list, that means calling the range function by using 0 and 5 as its argument will return a list starting from 0 up to 4. Okay, but actually this is not 100% true. We will see it why this is not 100% true in a while. So the formal format of calling the range function is call the range function with a lower limit and a upper limit with its argument. Then the range function returns a list of numbers starting from the lower limit and going up to upper limit minus 1. Upper limit minus 1. This is the list returned by the range function. There is another formal format of the range function. You can call range by using lower limit, upper limit and step value. However, this range function returns a list having elements as lower limit, then other elements, say x, y, some other elements up to upper limit minus 1. Less than or equal to upper limit minus 1. Okay. Less than or equal to upper limit minus 1. I will explain you practically what I mean here. Upper limit minus 1. And the difference between different elements of the list is step value. Step value. What I mean here is that if I write range 0 comma 10 to, it is going to return a list having, which will start with 0. The next element is going to be 2 because step value is 2 here. Okay, so 0 after 2, then 4, then 6, then 8, and then not 10. It is up to 8 because highest number possible in the list is up to 10 minus 1, means up to 9. But since 9 cannot come under this list, because a step difference also should be 2, therefore the maximum element possible in this list is 8. So hopefully you are getting all these stuff. Now let's try the range practically. If I write here range 1,7, it is going to result a list starting from 1 up to 6. What it returns is range 1,7 as it is. So the range function did not return the list. But what does this means? Let me write something else. Let's store whatever the value returned by range in the variable x. Range 1,7. If you press enter, then x should contain a list whose elements will be starting from 1 up to 6. But no, x also contains range 1,7. Now let's check type of x. Type of x. It is not showing that the type of x is list. It is saying that type of x is range. That's why I told that when I say range function returns a list, I am not 100% correct. the data type returned by the range function is of type range. Okay, but you can assume that a range function returns a list whose first value is the lower limit and the last value is upper limit minus 1. You can assume like that. So let me check if 2 in x or not. Yes, 2 in x. 2 is there in x because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 all are in x. Now let's check if 7 in x or not. If 7 in x or not. No, 7 is not in x. Only up to 6 are there in x. So actually, whatever is returned by range behaves like a list, but it is not a list data type. You cannot print them like a list. This is very important for us to understand range before we start learning about iterative statements or loops in Python. The range function can be called by using three arguments. Let's call the range function by using three arguments, range 1, 7, 2. Now idea is the starting value is 1, the lower limit is 1, upper limit is 7 minus 1 is equal to 6, and the steps are 2. So first you need to start from 1, then go to 3, then go to 5, then go to 7. So 1, 3, 5 and 7 are going to be elements of the range here. Let's store whatever returned by range in the variable x. Now let's check if 1 in x or not. Yes, true. Now check if 2 in x or not. No, 2 is not there in x. Let's try this one. Range 0, 10, 2. Range x is equal to range 0, 10, 2. 0 is the lower limit, 10 is the upper limit, and 2 is the step. Press enter. Now type x. X is the range 0, 10, 2. Now check if 9 in x or not. No, 9 is not in x. 8 in x or not. Yes, 8 in x. 10 in x or not. No, 10 is also not in x. When you write something like that, you can go maximum up to the upper limit minus 1. Okay, so you can go up to 9. But since your step count is 2, so you cannot reach to 9 because you will start from 2, go up to 8, and the next value is 10 where you cannot go. So your highest limit is 8 here in this case. We can have negative step value in the range function. Means if I write here range 5, 0, -1, therefore perhaps a list will be returned. Okay, you can assume that a list will be returned in which the first element is going to be 5 and you can go 1 before the 0. Okay, so 1 before the 0 is 1 because we are starting from 5 and the element which is most near to 0 is 1. So starting with 5, then 4, then 3, then 2, then 1. These are the elements in the range 5, 0, -1. Now just tell me, what are the different elements in the range 9, 3, -1? In the range 9, 3, -1. Starting from the 9 and you can go up to 4. So 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Starting from the 9 and go up to 4. If I write here range 10, 1, -2. 10, 1, -2. What the values are possible here? You can start from 10 and go up to 2. Okay, you cannot go beyond that. You can start from 10 and you can go up to 2. Okay, but the step count is going to be 2. Okay, 2 in the reverse order. So you can go here like 10, 8, 6, 4, 2, and that's it. Let's try something more interesting. If you type your range, you start from a lower value, means your lower limit is going to be lower value. Suppose that it is 2, your upper limit is going to be a higher value. Suppose that it is 9 and your step count is in negative. Can you do it? Let's press enter and see what happens. Let's store whatever returned by range in the variable x. X is equal to range 29 minus 1 to 9 minus 1. Press enter. And if you want to see what the values are present in x, I'm giving you a trick. You write here 4y in x. For y in x, give a colon and then print y. Print y. And here you will get all the values present in whatever is returned in x. Okay, because directly by printing x, you cannot get all those values. But like this, you can get all those values. We are going to learn the for loop in the later videos of this session. But here, you just remember that if you want to know what the values are stored in the range, then you can use this trick. Well, for y in range variable, print y. So whatever is there in the range variable will be printed here. So press enter, and it prints nothing. Actually, there is nothing inside the range variable. Let me try something else, otherwise you will get more confused. X is equal to range, and let me write here something in reverse, 9 comma 2. That means you have to start from 9 and you have to go up to 2, and your steps are going to be minus 2. Can you tell me what the values are possible here? You can start from 9 and can go up to 3. Okay, because 3 is 1 before 2. Okay, so starting from 9, you will have 9, 7, 5 and 3, because the step count is also 2. So type here for y in x, give a colon and print y. Print y. And here you have all the values, 9, 7, 5, 3. If you want to know what the values are present in any range, you can just have a print like this. We are going to learn about the for loop in the later videos. Now, our question still remains that why we do not have any value in this range? Why do not have any value in this range? Because you have to start from 2 and you have to go towards the numbers lesser than 2, and you are trying to find 9. 9 cannot be found in that direction. You have to start from 2 and go towards the direction of 1, 0, minus 1, like that. There you are not going to find a 9. Therefore, here you can see that the range returns an empty list. That's how when you try to print the various values of this range, you got an empty list. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. In the next video, we are going to see various iteration or looping statements in Python. See you in the next video.